So initially, before it knows the fall rate, that estimate's going to be way off.
We decided to go out radio sonde hunting again, tempted by the prediction that the sonde would land on Metro Melbourne. This should be an easy recovery, but if you stay tuned, you'll see a few ways this could go wrong.
So now you see that's coming in here, it's now in the outer, just a bit past Alinda. So we're going to go up there and wait for it, hoping that's going to come back into there. So yeah, it's coming in, coming right in. Of course, if it lands there, right in the middle of Eastlink, that's a bit of a pain. Right. Seems fairly settled that it's going to be somewhere around here.
With the balloon only just having burst, the predictions will take a bit of time to settle.
See, now we've got the old east-west problem, only this time it's the north-south problem. Notice Mitcham Road is divided as well, so it's actually here, 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 or here. So we can take that back street.
At this point, the prediction is pretty well settled. We just have to be there.
Is it still in the radio?
Oh, now it's north. Lands in the park, where probably not as screwed as if it lands in on one of these properties. So it's going from up there to there to there. It's going a bit left of the prediction. Yeah, that's going quite a bit left of the prediction.
The prediction of where the sonde will fall, of course, uses data gathered in part by the previous sonde launch. If the weather has changed in an unpredictable manner since then, so will the wind, and so will where it lands. Annoyance number one, it gets stuck in a tree. Annoyance number two is, of course, power lines, adding danger to the mix.
Oh, there it is. Oh, now that's a risky recovery if there ever was one.
We actually weren't alone. Another sonde chaser turned up shortly after us. We were first, though.
One's not.
It's gonna be high voltage.
Yeah. 11 kilovolts?
Yeah, probably.
Alright, judging by the fact it just flew out of the tree, I think the string's been yanked on.
Well,
Mark noticed they broke the census walk. did you see it on the roof?
What? No, that was up in that tree, up
was
there.
It, was it up in the tree?
Yes, it was literally in the top of that tree.
Oh,
it's blue. Oh, and
So with the first one successfully retrieved, we thought we'd try again. The stakes are a little higher with this one. The earlier prediction put this a little outside the metro area, but the weather has changed and the predictions shifted a little out since then. This can be trickier out here, depending on where exactly it lands. By the road or just off it is generally fine, but if it lands in a large regional backyard, we're not exactly getting it. Can't really go and knock on someone's door at this time of night. As time goes on, the prediction just gets further and further out. We continue heading in the direction of the balloon.
The prediction's gone way out now.
As the sonde falls through the atmosphere, it hits different wind layers travelling in different directions. Here it is supposed to fall into a layer that will cause it to turn around and go back the other way, but the layer isn't where the prediction says it is.
Take the next right onto Bates Park Road, then turn left to stay on Bates Park Road.
Okay, that stayed pretty stable towards out there, so... The balloon's getting close to being overhead, but it's deviating south from the prediction. It's kind of hovering around the road.
It's looking pretty good. The predicted landing is around where the road is. That's just about the best we can hope for.
So yeah, unfortunately it's a 100 meters back that way behind the house.
So close yet so far. If it wasn't 12:30, we'd go and ask permission to retrieve it. But unfortunately this one's just not a success. You might think this was pretty unlikely to result in a recovery, but you'd be surprised how often the tall trees by the roadside snag it out of the air, giving you much better odds of catching it than the small area of the road compared to the field would lead you to believe. Nothing left to do but head home before any of the other local wildlife decided to try anything. For more content on surprisingly technical hobbies you may not have known were a thing, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.